Hi everybody, I'm Ms. Vixen, Vixen Experience, and I have sitting with me the beautiful Tay Jones. We're going to sit down and talk to you guys for this month's Dream Catcher series. Tay, thank you so much for sitting with me.
Thank you for having me.
We met on set of Kendall's video, If This Wasn't a Dog. We had so much fun, and after meeting you and getting a filthy personality, I know you just have to sit down. So again, thank you. So, what exactly is it that you do?
I am an actress that models. So that wraps it up. I do dance and sing, but the acting is just my main thing, and that's really where I want everything to go. Straight to that. So, yeah.
Okay, so what experience do you have and like what have you done?
I actually went to college for musical theater. So I started there, and I've done a lot of extra work. I did Harold and Kumar's Christmas. I did Transformers 3 when they were all in Detroit. I've done like some short films. I'm actually interning with a short film director now, so I'm doing that. And I'm also playing a very significant role in the off-Broadway musical entitled Ready to Die. It's about Baby.
Yeah,
it's about Baby. And I'm playing Little Kim.
Nice.
So
I didn't even like the last one I played, okay, in the movie.
The story?
Role, it's just like the character. I just wasn't feeling her as Kim in the movie.
Yeah, I think physically I fit Kim very well. Like, we're the exact same size as far as like the height, and then like just me as a person, I kind of act like Kim. Like, I'm very
big person.
Yeah, I'm very out there, and like she's very like diva queenish, and that's me.
Right.
So, who better to play Kim?
So, outside of acting, where does modeling play a role in what you do? How do you feel about that?
A lot of acting comes with modeling, to where modeling is the same. The only thing is a lot of modeling goes with like the camera, pictures, stuff like that. I actually began modeling because as far as acting, they really wanted me to do a lot of stuff that has to do with modeling. Like, okay, well, you're pretty, so do this, or we can use you for like this poster for this. And I'm just like, okay, maybe if I start modeling, it'll open up some doors as far as acting, you know what I mean?
Right.
So, yeah, really that's how I really got into acting. I mean, I'm sorry, modeling.
Okay. And with the acting, like, I know you said you went to school for like performance, so do you prefer doing a musical or do you rather just act strictly?
I would prefer to do a musical just because I have so much energy.
Okay.
And like all of that, but honestly, musicals are very exhausting, very extremely exhausting. Not only do you have to act and like really be believable, but you have to learn music and dance moves on top of still connecting with like your ensemble and your, you know, like, yes, it's just so much. So like straight plays a lot of the time is just focused on one thing.
Okay.
So it's a lot more drama and it's less like, oh, time step,
song,
not ballet. Like, it's just, you know, so like straight plays is where it's at as far as like being an actress.
Okay. So in terms of modeling, what has your modeling experience been? What exactly have you done? I know you've been teaching a lot of things.
Yes. I've done like so many web features, like the web magazines and G-Girls and Fantasy series. Just recently, I was published my first magazine, As Is. Thank you, As Is magazine. Pages 50, 51. That's my spread. That's on newsstands right now, I think. Excuse me. Then after that, I did a Kurt Cobain's video, Drinking My Cup remix with 2 Chainz and Joel Santana. That was the very first one, and that was featuring in TV Jams, Jam of the Week. So that was really good. And now I'm in the acting of video with Miguel in Broadway, featuring Rich Montana and Rico Love. And I'm like the lead model of that.
Yes, you are. Straight face. Slay these all FaceTime. I love it. You did a good job in that one.
Thank you.
So outside of acting and modeling, what do you do with that? Like, if you're not on call for something, what does the regular day look like?
Really working. Like, I'm a bartender and kind of waitress and stuff just on the side, just to, you know, pay bills or whatever. Whenever modeling doesn't, you know, come to her, asking her if I have no gigs. days consist of focusing on my career. I do a lot of research, which a lot of models in the urban industry don't do. So I do like a lot of research. I make sure that, like, for instance, like my friend, he's a director. He actually got me into the Kirk Gomez video and that video. And I like make sure that I connect with new type of people, make sure I just network and I really focus on my craft, because that's the most important part to me. So
okay, so I can't imagine. I'm just not really timing. It's just not my thing. So what type of discipline, or what have you had to change anything about yourself in order to actually, you know, make all your shoes think it's work? And then also the discipline is like, I don't have like a 9-to-5, so I'm not gonna have that same paycheck every week, that same place. Tell me something.
Okay, the first thing, now you know I'm not from here. So
where are you from?
Originally I'm from Youngstown, Ohio. It's like a small town, like right on the edge of Ohio, right next to PA.
Okay.
When I was 16, I moved to Detroit with my family, my two sisters, and my mom. So that's more so home, because that's where my family is. But Youngstown still has my heart. I still work there, and I still go back and visit as often as I can, which is not very often. But I still go back. So.
Okay. So you moved to New York when?
Originally in 2008, right after high school, I came here straight from college. Like right after the summer, I came straight here, and then I lived here for about like on and off for 2.5 years, so until 2010. But then I left. I went home for about a year and a half because I was homeless for 3 days, which was like the worst experience ever. So I just was like, and like I really didn't want to leave, but it was just like I had nowhere to go. I like here in the city, I have no family.
Right.
Like, not even a distant cousin, so I had nowhere to go.
Right.
So I went back home for about a year and a half, and I was very nervous to move back. So I'm like, I really don't want to struggle again, and I really don't want that to happen. But not being here, it just really made me unhappy, because I knew if I, like, in Detroit, I was doing my thing, obviously. But I just felt like being here, I could make it grow so much further.
Right.
It just really put me in a hole, just mentally, that I just wasn't here doing what I knew I could do best. So I came here for vacation and just never left.
It just turned into home. So we're home now.
Yes, this is home.
We're glad you're in New York. So what are you currently working on?
Whoa.
That's a loaded question.
Yes, I have so many different projects. The first thing, I actually have my website is coming.
Nice.
And like I've been working on a website for about a year and a half, but I just really wanted it to get to the point to where I didn't have to tell people to go to my website, just wanting to visit. Like, oh, you know, like, who's this girl in this magazine? Who's this girl here? Who's this girl there? And they just easily just Google, and then my website comes up. You know, but I wanted to make sure my resume was built to a certain extent, you know? So that's the first thing. I also have posters coming out. Those will be out probably the beginning to the middle of August.
Okay.
So posters.
Leo.
Yes. So right time for your birthday. Birthday gift.
That'll be a great giveaway.
Yes.
We'll definitely do a couple giveaways with those.
Okay, great. Right after that, which I'm actually in the process of filming now, I want to do kind of like a video blog, but I want it to be like a reality show.
Okay.
And it's basically going to be one of my life as a model and an actress, and basically my way to the top and like all of that. You know what I mean?
Okay, so basically you want to put in yourself as you go on shoes.
Yes.
And like the people that
but
you
I want meet. It to be everything, like from my work to like struggles to like everything. Like,
I
want
online diet different things.
Yes.
You want to prompt them.
Yes, like yes, gotcha. Exactly. So that's like the big thing that I really want that to drop. Like that's really my expectation, probably for like the new year.
Okay.
So that's like another big thing. And also, I just started this campaign. It's called Take 14. And I am tweeting Sean Mockham, who is the CEO and the photographer for King Magazine. I've been tweeting him every day to show him my determination. I made a video and everything. So that's also like, by the end of this year, I plan on being King Magazine. He's gonna know
like,
who I am.
No, not that I want to be. I plan on doing this.
Yes.
It's gonna happen. We're just working out the dates.
Yes. Exactly. Like, I'm just really trying to make sure that he knows, because, like, there are so many models that get featured in those magazines. And then you don't look like you see them, but not really. There's just kind of this girl who was in King.
Right.
Well, I want him to feel like having me in his magazine would be an asset. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not
going to
be.
And it would. Exactly. Because you're not just going to be in someone's magazine. You actually have a plan for the future. There's a life plan. There's a goal that you're actually in.
Exactly. So that way, when I do feature in his magazine, he'd be like, you know, she featured in this magazine.
That's
first. Like, this is the first national magazine that they featured in. You know what I mean? So, really, like that.
This is why we need the tape, okay? We continue on.
No, it's okay. So those are really my main goals as far as like the near future.
Okay.
So I really want to just focus on those right now. But of course we have like hair campaigns like that in the making, you know.
Right.
In the works.
Prior to working on building up on. Okay, so what do you do for fun? I mean, do you have time for fun? Like between regular work, shoot work, like?
I mean, being a model and an actress, like, I consider that fun. Like,
okay. That's
fun for me. So, as long as I can fix my little high, like, okay, I haven't had a shoot in a while. You know what I mean? Like, even though I know I'm working, I really need my supporters and everybody to see.
Right.
Tay is working. They don't see, like, the footwork. They only see, like, the outcome.
Right, you see the finished product.
Exactly. So, really, I try to make sure that I stay relevant and I stay consistent. So,
brand out there.
Exactly. As I build it, because it's not even done. It's
right.
Nowhere near done yet. So really that's it. Yeah.
Okay. So where can we find you?
Well, of course I'm in TV Jams. The jam of the week. But my Twitter is @SayNatay, SayNatay. And I also have another one, Pronoxinatay, PRONOUN. NATAY, just in case you couldn't throw it out.
Right. I know.
Because you know some people can't. So.
They're there.
Yes.
So, okay, so we've got you on Twitter. Facebook?
Natay, NATE, @ R Jones.
Okay, so we got Facebook, we have Twitter. What is your website? Is it up yet? Or
no, not yet.
Okay.
But it will be, it's actually going to be pronounced Natay.com.
Okay.
So, yeah, but that'll be up. Hopefully, we're anticipating the beginning of August.
This one is my birthday. If I haven't dropped enough clues. Well, I just want to say, Natay, thank you so much for sitting with
me. Thank you so much for having me.
I really appreciate you here. You have a beautiful spirit. You're a beautiful girl. And we know that we'll see you in Canada for the end of the year. And we know that we're going to see you Broadway and live. Like, girl, I interviewed her.
My first official interview. This is my first official.
Here.
Right here.
Vixen Experience.
Vixen Experience. Because you're experiencing these Vixens. Right here.
Right here. Guys, thank you so much for stopping by. Make sure to check out Natay. She will be in King. She's in As Is on Stands Now. And I'm Vixen, Miss Vixen, with VixenExperience.com. Keep dreaming, guys.